Okay, so it's all just going through the options list as to what you can have, what you can't have, things to suit different environments, and I'll just walk you through some of those here really. So first one springs to mind is motors. So the way the machine's driven these days, to reduce the maintenance down to the absolute minimum, we go for a direct drive system, and that basically involves three-phase, four-pole motors. These will be 0.75 kilowatt, driving through a range of gearboxes, depending on the width of the machine and the amount of power we're putting through it. But on standard machines, up to 2.2 meters, we'll run 0.75 kilowatt with either a 15-to-1 or a 20-to-1 reduction gearbox. So mounted directly on the end of the shafts. Our standard fitment is Motovario. I know it says IE2 on these, but all motors going forward for 2021 will actually be IE3, and they'll be UL rated. That'll be our standard motor drive, and they'll be Motovario. We've run these motors. They're certainly not a budget motor, and they're certainly not the very top end, but we've found them to be very, very reliable, and long, long life out of the gearboxes as well. Very, very few failures on them. Very few indeed. So good units, and we've run these for probably 10, 12 years. But we offer other types as well. We generally go to European motors. I wish I'd stick with European motors. One of the higher grade ones is the SEW brand. They offer a range of upgrades, and you can spend anything you want on these things, but they're very good. Now, the SEW drive offers a torque lock system. So rather than us having a hollow shaft gearbox straight over a 8mm key on a 25mm shaft, we go to a 30mm shaft that's keyless. And what the SEW offers is a torque lock system where we have two taper locks on either side of the gearbox, and we're just able to slide that on a plain shaft, tighten all that up with a row of Allen keys or Allen screws, and that's enough to pinch onto the shaft. And the reason we do that is for removal. The environment these things are in, especially in food factories where there's constant washing, power washing, juice from whatever, it does get ingrained no matter what we do. And sometimes gearbox removal can be tricky, especially on a keyed shaft. So the torque lock idea really does mean we just undo all the screws and it just drops off and around. It's a really, really good system, but it does come at a price. SEW also offer a better coating systems on the motors and gearboxes for longer life. The water protection is just that little bit higher as well. We can have forced air fans. There's a load of stuff we can have on that SEW, but you could quite easily just give us your specification, and then we can accommodate that by putting whatever brand, whatever style you really want on this sort of machine. So that's all available. So there's six drives for the six clod rollers on this side, and again we've got the opposite on the other side driving the spiral rollers. What else can I tell you about? So other options we can talk about are remote greasing. As you'd imagine, these bearings are running incredibly slowly to what they're designed to do. Most bearing life is tested at full 2000 RPM. We're about 100. So the bearing life on here is exceptionally long. Obviously, you can see the bearings are all mounted on the outside of the chassis. They're not up against the debris and the soil and the moisture. So they generally do last a very, very long time. They all come greasable or non. They're all accessible with a grease gun, but we are finding more and more customers are just looking for ease, just ease of maintenance. If anything's difficult, it doesn't get done as often. So what we offer now is a direct remote grease pipe to every bearing. So we run, obviously on this six row system, we've got six for the spiral rollers on this side, six for the clod rollers, and then obviously we've got this transfer or feed off roller on the end here, That has its own separate grease nipple there as well. So again, we've got the same on the other side. So that's an option that you can have. I quite like it. Just why wouldn't you? Makes life easy. It's not particularly expensive. The other thing we can offer, which does certainly helps the other manufacturers install these into their lines, which is electrical conduit. So stainless steel, it's pre-cut for your flexible conduit that runs from one side of the machine. So all of these wires coming in from each motor, all the holes in the conduit are all pre-cut. So we can put a gland in there, run the cable straight in, all of that wiring work's all done for you. Speeds the job up tremendously. Sealed, stainless steel. Again, really not very expensive for us to put that on for you as well. So that's becoming quite a popular little addition. So other options, what have we got? Probably just one more I could show you here at the moment. Electric actuators. So if I'll be honest, 99% of the machines that go out of the factory, they come with electric actuators. So what's that doing? We talked about clod roller adjustment, and there's two adjustments on the machine for the clod rollers in terms of position. One is gap and one is height. So the way we lift the clod rollers up and down is a subframe within the chassis. If you look here, we have quite a substantial steel plate that's runs through a linkage to this electric ram. And when we power the ram in and out, this top, we call it the up and down plate, traverses up and down. You can see where it moves on the slot. And what that does, all of the clod rollers and motor units, each one of them is connected to that plate. Both sides are connected to each other. So electric actuator goes up and down, clod rollers go up and down, all together in one hit. A basic machine can just have a manual turnbuckle on it. Anything wrong with that? Not really. It's does everything that the electric actuator does. Are you likely to adjust it? Probably not. Obviously, we have to lift the guard up, stop the machine. It's quite hard. It's doable, but it's physical. People just like to press a button. So, as I say, most of these go out with the electric actuator on. They've got limit switches in there, so we set them in the factory to give you the exact range that you're looking for. So that's an option we've got for that one. As I say, electric motors down the side. One other option we can mention to you, we do actually do a hydraulic drive version of the same machine. So where you're in a situation where you want to power it hydraulically, rather than use the motor gearbox, we have an option where we can put a direct drive hydraulic motor on the end of every shaft. So there's always a situation where somebody wants something different, and we can offer you that as well. Okay, a couple more things I can talk to you about option-wise, but just the simple ones. Colour, we offer everything. As long as you've got a RAL code or a BS number, we can give you any colour you like for that. And we also produce this in stainless steel as well. That's an option that's quite popular. And then really finally, we give you options on the bearings. So depending on where this one's gonna go. In a potato grader, doing 6 weeks a year, standard run-of-the-mill NSK bearings is what we offer. No problems with that. 24/7 in a food factory, 52 weeks of the year, we offer a range of bearings. We do food safe bearings, RHP, and Technic is another one springs to mind. All on the website, we can quote you for whichever way you want to go on that. Big variation in prices as well. Don't be afraid to ask if there's a particular bearing unit you particularly want to use, we'll accommodate that as well. Okay. All right, thank you very much. I think that covers all the options.